Alright, yeah, welcome back to some more XCOM 2. So, in the previous episode, we ended up doing a guerrilla ops mission, and it went very well, except for, I think, Jace was the one who got hit, so he's going to be out for probably not very long, thanks to the Advanced Warfare Center. Yeah, only 4 days. Looks like we need to take Ezio down on our next mission. Speaking of missions, what is our objective? Well, we're going to be taking the Skulljack on the next mission with us, so if we find any officers, we want to get right up personal with them and then stab them in the face with a sharp electronic blade. So that's what we're going to be doing. Alien encryption research is something that we're going to be doing straight after plated armor, which is going to be finished in a day, and hopefully we have the supplies in order to upgrade our units with that kind of thing. I think it's the same as magnetic weapons, we only have to buy it once and then we can equip it to people, but I'm not quite sure, don't quote me on that. So, the main objective though is to get to New Chile for this this dark mission here, because we really want to start fighting this Avatar project. So, we're going to make contact with South Africa here. We already made contact with East Africa, built a relay there, so it's only going to cost us 40 intel. And then the next one's going to cost us 80, so yeah, we're going to cut it close. We're going to need a little bit of intel here and there, so yeah.
Commander, the aliens have made significant progress toward their goals. New advent facilities are cropping up around
Bagger,
the world.
They've got another one. Sabotage the alien facility. That one's even further away. Jesus Christ, we have to literally make contact with the rest of the world to get there. Maybe we could go from Eastern Europe. I don't think that saves us any time though, because we've already made this journey. So that'd be 1, 2, 3, 4, as opposed to 1, 2, 3, 4, yeah. So we're literally continuing along the path that we've got, but it's really vitally important we start making contact now then.
Attempting to establish.
I am sure you will find the results to be as intriguing as
fantastic, we have plated armor. So we can now make predator armor. New item available, reinforced frame. I'm assuming that's for our mech. And then we've got proving ground projects, which is exosuit and spider suit. I think spider suit is really good for people like our sharpshooters who get to use a grappling hook, if I remember rightly, to get onto rooftops without using drain pipes and things like that. So it can be really useful. Exosuit, I can't quite remember. I think that is the suit that was on about last episode where you can get rocket arms and flamethrowers and that kind of thing attached to it. Let's have a look. Reinforced frame, yeah, that looks like a spark unit. It is. Predator armor, that's our next upgrade. Spider suit for the grappling hook, yeah, and the exosuit, which heavy variant of plated armor. More importantly, we may add a heavy weapon to it as well, which is pretty good. And oh, a lot of our research is now instant, so we might as well do it. Advent Stun Lancer Autopsy, instant.
The Advent Stun Lancer was apparently outfitted with the intention of serving as a civilian peacekeeping unit within the city centers. Although they are equipped with weapons capable of administering non-lethal blows, recent reports indicate an increasingly aggressive stance taken by these units.
Yes, I have felt their increasingly aggressive stance several times. It's not pleasant. That sounded wrong, but
clearly intended for these units to be their means of dealing with any unruly civilians within the city centers. It seems they have come to rely on more brutal means of pacification in the time since.
We've actually unlocked the Arc Blade thanks to that, actually, which is the next level to our Ranger's Sword. Not going to push that too much unless we have spare resources for it, because we really do need to make sure that we've got the resources for the plated armor.
The turrets we see employed by Advent throughout their various facilities and security checkpoints are automated, much in the same way the alien mechanized units are. A significant amount of time was likely spent developing the optical sensors and targeting system, which I expect Shin will want to thoroughly examine following the disassembly process.
Very nice.
Advent doesn't seem to have any issues stationing completely autonomous weapons in close proximity to the people in those cities. Really shows you how much.
So we've got a defense matrix, which I do believe. Defense matrix repurposes the recovered Advent turrets as automated defenses to be deployed in the case of a ground assault on the Avenger. If you remember in XCOM 1, There was a mission where your home base got attacked, and I think that's what the defense matrix is for, if we want to be prepared for that kind of thing. Right, alien encryption takes 8 days. Let's see if there's anything maybe we want more. No, we'll push alien encryption. We might actually be able to get the research, all the objectives done for the next mission.
I'll contact you when I have a full report available.
All right. So we got our research gone. 2 days until we've got a skulljack. I feel like we already had one though, because
just give the word and I'll get started, infantry. Commander.
Yeah, we already have one. So why am I building one? It's a good question.
Tell me something, Doctor. Must have been pretty cushy working with Advent, living in the colonies.
Project.
So why the sudden change of heart?
Like most people, I wanted to believe that the aliens were legitimately interested in peace. Although they left me little choice when it came to working with them, I admit, I was drawn to the sense of normalcy they offered. It was a mistake.
You should have known better. The aliens would never have come here if they wanted peace.
As I said, it was a mistake. One I hope to atone for through my efforts with Xcom.
Then I'd say you've got your work cut out for
yes.
you.
Yeah, we made a mistake. I made a mistake. Trying to build the skulljack when we actually finished the research. We'd already done that, essentially, so... have we got a spare engineer? We don't. No, so we're not really expanding much at the moment. Don't think we really need to. We've got plenty of power. We've got enough contacts to get to the next black site mission. And I don't think there's any buildings right now that we want to make, other than maybe the defense matrix that we want to push for. We might want to expose the power coil. We can also get these supplies and alien alloys and things like that for doing it as well. So perhaps we want to do something like that. Maybe when Jace is fully recovered, we'll take the person out of the Advanced Warfare Center if there's nobody who needs healing after that point. All right, let's continue to make contact anyway. Let's not mess about. And sweet. Alright, an extra 70 supplies.
New regional contact.
And now we can make contact with the Black Site area, which is exactly what we're going to be doing. We can now go to West Africa as well. But there's nothing there for us right now, so we're not going to be doing that. Alright. Before we make contact with that area, let me just check something. Engineering.
Hello, Commander.
Purchase items. Build items, please. Armor. Predator armor. We need Advent Trooper corpses and alien alloys. 20 of them. We've only got 7. Corpses we'll obviously get as we go along. I'm kind of regretting selling a fair few of them to the black market now, but we can get the alien alloys from the black market as well, hopefully. So let's just continue to make contact with our areas. It's going to cost us 80 intel. We've got 115. We could make a relay here, so it costs 45, but that costs us 75 supplies, and we kind of probably need those supplies later down the line, so we might as well spend our intel going to New Chile.
Setting course for Sector 4, Chile.
Yeah, we really need to make sure that this bar does not get any larger than it already is. So, pushing on to this black site mission is a really good idea.
To establish local regional
dragon
contact.
Rounds. Yes! Dragon rounds are a specific kind of bullet that sets people on fire, which is pretty good. It's kind of the ammo of choice that I wanted to put on. Ooh, a supply raid. We actually need this. View raid location. Alright, let's go.
Setting course for sector
really do with some alien
one.
Alloys. The supplies will be nice. I don't know if you get intel or anything like that, but it'd be nice if we could get that too. Sweet.
Commander Tigan and Shen aren't going to be happy if we don't put the skulljack to good use. We should have one of our soldiers equip it before they...
Thank you for reminding me this time. So we should have dragon rounds for our sniper. We're going to leave Dave out of this one. He's been in... It's been in the firing line for far too long, so we'll get Blood Gold in there. We do need Ezio as our our ranger. We're going to give him the Skulljack. Although, desperately, I want to give him the Talon rounds. And speaking of ammunition, Dragon rounds for Blood Gold, so that when he hits, he actually sets them on fire. Is pretty nice. You're actually a gunslinger, aren't you? Yeah, we wanted to go down the gunslinger route, so... Yeah, he's going to be fine on this one. We don't need a height advantage or anything like that with him. Let's get... Let's get our Spark in there again. He's so good. So good. And we'll bring Alex with us, and we need a specialist as well. Josh hasn't been on a mission in a while. I believe you're our medic as well. Oh, we can give you an upgrade as well. Soldier abilities. Yeah, revival protocol. So, Josh gets the med kit. Now we have to make it available. Make utility items available, please. Thank you. Med kit for you. Dragon rounds for you. Grenade. If we see an officer, we can take him out. Yeah, we should be good. We're a little low on explosives. I'm not going to take a flashbang just for that reason. But we should be good here. Yeah, let's go. We've got a spark with a rocket launcher, and that can do a fair amount of damage if it gets in. Plus, getting up close and personal is pretty sweet. With his slam attack. Alright, let's begin the mission.
Trying to move an Advent troop transport, the Resistance disabled during a recent skirmish. There's an opportunity here for us to pull some of their technology off the transport. But we'll need to secure the area and eliminate any remaining hostiles to make that happen.
Alright, Operation Diamond Tomb. So we gotta kill everything, which is some of my favorite missions. Because I just like murdering enemies. There you go. And we got to avoid taking out the supplies along the way as well. We really need those alien alloys. Should enter concealed, I believe.
Menace 1-5, the Advent troop transport is nearby. Engage and eliminate all hostile forces.
Yeah, cool. Alright. We can actually get Blood Gold up here anyway. He is our gunslinger, but at the moment he's not really like locked into that right now. He only returns fire if he gets shot at, I believe. Yeah, when targeted by enemy fire, just fire back with a pistol. It's not terribly important to us. Right. So, with that in mind, let's start pushing up a little bit. I'm assuming they're going to be up in this region here. But you know what they say when you assume. Alright. It should be good for a yellow move. Should be.
Is equal.
Gotta find out where they are. They don't know where we are either, so we've got that going for us. We didn't trigger anything, so I'm gonna move everybody else up into this kind of spot. Blood Gold will take you up into that spot there. Should have full range of the map from there, in theory.
Venga, vamos, vamos.
And then let's move everybody else up. Nice, fast, yellow move, just to make sure that we get stuff done. And... I hear things. That kind of sounded like a viper. I cannot confirm or deny such things yet, but... You can't get there in a blue move. Interesting. Alright. Let's bring Ezio... around here, then. Spotted anything? No. Maybe I'll move Blood Gold up here, then, so he's got a little bit of extra range. Can't make it there in a blue move, but he can go right here where Ezio was. And... you can't get there without smashing windows. Dang it! Well, I guess we're just going to move you
orders confirmed. On the move.
Around these corners here. And Josh, go there.
Recibido.
Overwatch.
Scanning.
Overwatch active.
Alright. Blood gold. Get up into your perch. We'll put you here for an easy escape, I guess. Nobody else needs to go up there. Does not grant us a bonus to line of sight at all. So let's continue probing a little bit forward. Still nothing, eh? Alright, let's probe a little bit further. Still nothing. They must all be in this building, I'm guessing. Maybe they're in that direction. Maybe we've gone the wrong way. We'll see. Well, if we have gone the wrong way, at least we know that there's nothing over here. Right. Let's push Alex up a little bit. And stick Josh over here. Blood gold, pistol overwatch. And our spark unit over there. Oh, crap. Oh, I thought he was going to jump through the window. Thank Christ for that. That would have been annoying. Nothing again. We can't quite make it across this little frozen river without making yellow moves. I guess we can make this move, though.
Andiamo.
Still nothing. We are at the back of the map right now. They're likely in here then. And I think, yeah, this is the border for the rest of the map. So if we come across here and then engage the building from this side, we should be good to go. So, let's just move everybody up this way, I guess. Yellow move there for Josh. Balls. Alright, we know where they are. They haven't triggered, of course, but that's two sectoids and a viper. At least we know where they are. So we've got that going for us. And Blood Gold can somewhat hit them from where he is. I'm going to move him up a little bit closer.
Scanning.
I don't think we're at risk of triggering the pod at all, even if we move up a bit.
Entering Overwatch.
But in case we are, we have a couple of Overwatches. I'd like to know where they're going. I think they were moving this way. If my headphones are anything to go by. Right, Josh, please find them in your line of sight again. I'd be grateful. Moving up a bit and staying in full cover right there. Doesn't grant us a view. Yeah. Oh, that sucks. I'd rather engage these as they are without any further units joining the battle. So let's move Sparky up. Alex. Half cover here. It's not great, but it's fine. And then Ezio. Who is an easy target for these sectoids because he has the shaken debuff.
Got it covered.
But it does mean we have to get a kill with him. Here they come. Oh my god, that's a different one. We've got a new guy. These guys put up shields, I think, and make it an absolute nightmare to engage. Okay. I don't like this, because we've got three units here. And three really bad units here. Do not like it at all. Alex, have you got a decent move? Some half cover there.
Affirmative.
I feel like we should wait until these guys leave and those guys come back. We've got a couple of turns before their route meets up again. In theory.
This way.
Would simply like to just know where they are, though, that's the thing. Because it's really risky engaging two sectoids, a Viper, a Muton, a new shield guy, and a trooper. That seems like the worst possible thing we could do right now. Which is why I don't want to do it. I'm still moving people up, though, because we have to work towards engaging at the very least. But...
Overwatch.
Affirmative, covering now.
I'm going to move Spark out of range of maybe their line of sight. And Overwatch.
Covering now.
Ah, they're coming towards us. Hopefully they don't spot us. They might do, they're turning. Oh dear, right, okay. Now's the time to engage then. I reckon we could probably... Yeah, we could land a grenade here. We could get Spark in range, make a shot, and then fire a rocket. Let me just check that... Yeah, it's this rock here that's blocking the shot, if anything. So if I move him, it has to be in such a way that we can get around the rock still. So, there. He's going to be our... spot. I think we want to land the rocket while we still can. 4-7. And then Ezio's in range to finish one off. Theoretically. He has a slash. Advent shield bearer. Ugh. Alex could move back here and still have a shot. She could also move up here and have a shot. Josh can come round here for full cover. And Blood Gold's got free reign on any that he wants. So the question is, do we set up any Overwatches? I think maybe we move Alex and Overwatch her.
Good copy. Moving on target.
Get her in full cover. 72, 62, 61. They're not great odds, so I think she's going to be...
I'm on it.
An Overwatch trap. Ezio is gonna clean up. Josh, you don't have very good shots from where you are, so I think full cover and Overwatch, so that if you do get one, then you're good to go. Blood Gold's gonna clean up. Rook. Take three actions. No action is turn ending. Multiple standard shots incur a shot recoil penalty, except for they don't because we have the upgrade for it. I think I'm going to overdrive, rocket, and have a shot. Just checking that. Rocket launcher does not. But we also have strikes, of course. We might actually be able to clean up this pod entirely then. So, let's try and kill their cover as well as hitting all of them. Here we go. Shredded all of their armor. Taken most of their life off.
Position revealed.
Spark's got a shot. Ezio's got a shot. Our sniper's got a shot. Alex gets an Overwatch. Takes out. Oh. Takes out the Muton. We hit the shield bearer. So we can kill one. Almost guaranteed, 81% there. Ezio needs to kill something. So we'll put him here. And slash. Cool. Without putting Spark into... Oh, crap. 64 on that turret. Yeah. I was hoping that wouldn't happen. Well, we can hope that this strike here kills him and then maybe the turret hits the Spark unit instead, because we really need Ezio to get out of this without taking a hit is the problem. 4-6. Potential that it just doesn't do anything with the amount of armor that it's got there. Does Spark have a shot? He doesn't. Alright, well, we take this strike. We need that to die. What? Oh my god, this couldn't be any worse. Could not be any worse. 75%, come on. Blood gold. Only time you need to hit. Right now. Praise the Lord! We've done it. Alright. Now it's up to the turret. What does the turret want to do? Be merciful. Do not hit Ezio. Oh, he's going for Ezio. Ezio's down. Yep. Well, we don't have to worry about getting him unshaken anymore. Silver lining, I suppose. You know? Alright. I'm so annoyed. Damn you, turret. So, get a shot on the turret. Take some of its armor off. Alex can't quite get a grenade in there. She could maybe move up closer. What's the kind of range on that? It might be close. If we move her... I'm not sure which one would be less tiles. Would it be that one or that one? Either way, she doesn't have a shot. So one of those has to be a place where she can get a shot. She can't hit there. She can't hit there. Are you kidding me? This is the worst thing in the world. Alright. Well, I guess we're moving up here then. See if we can land a grenade. Nope. Cannot. Best move Josh up so that he can get a shot on the next turn. And blood gold. Come on. Get that kill. I don't think you can, but get it. Beautiful. Not bad. Target eliminated. Alright. Overwatch. Yeah, so we know these guys are coming. Here they come. Do we get any Overwatch tricks? Nope, not a single one. Wonderful. We're really getting lucky today. Right. Let's line people up. We can probably... Is that a flank from there? I think it is, you know. So we can move there, get a flank on the Viper. The Viper's really bad for us right here. And pull us out of cover, and we don't want that. Or a sectoid. 72... Alright. Well, we've got that option to us. Let's move Alex
on the move.
Into a little bit of half cover here. There's no full cover to get, so that's the thing. And we could suppress. Even hit the Viper with a grenade and the sectoid. Josh, go into full cover. Get up nice and close. 59, 38, 35. Those are horrible odds. And then we got pretty horrible odds here as well. I hate everything about this turn. It is a foul, foul turn. Alright. 6-8. If we get really lucky, the sectoid dies. Alternatively, we've got just over a coin flip for the same kind of thing. Ugh. 59. We'll take Josh's best shot. 0% chance to crit, so there's no kill here. 6 damage is great, though. Means we can take that one out with a grenade if we want to do so. Also, 67% chance for Blood Gold to finish it off. And a 72 there. I think we'll take the 58 on the Viper. missed. Oh dear.
Control variable in targeting sequence.
Mm-hmm.
Critical ammo levels.
Do we not have a shot on you anymore? No, we do. I don't know why it's grayed out. Right. I guess if we grenade the Viper, we force a move out of it. Which means it's likely not going to use one of its special abilities, but it might go for a flank.
Here,
let's do it. Because if we go for a suppression, then he just uses one of his special abilities. Which... Oh, it didn't destroy his cover. And we just got blood gold left, so we take the chance to take out one of the units for less actions in their turn. Beautiful. I don't think you've missed today. I approve.
Got him.
All right. Let's see what the aliens do. Pointing at Spark. Got plans? No, going for Josh. Is that a... Yeah. Oh, you missed. Wonderful. All right. Sectoid still gets a psionic attack, though, which I don't think can miss. And you get an attack as well. Tries to poison our Spark unit. He's immune because he is not human. Right, psionic attack from the Sectoid. Puts him in decent cover as well. Have you gone for mind control or panic? Oh.
The aliens have found a way to mind control them now.
Yeah. That's reanimation. That's bad. Right, well, Blood Gold's out for this turn by the looks of it. Doesn't have any shots, so...
Moving to Overwatch.
We're out there. 38, 55, 93. If we take out the Sectoid, we take out the shield zombie. So we could move here, try to take out the Sectoid. We're going to need like two people on this though. Can we get... we could maybe get both of them in a grenade in the right position. But it's really risky. 93, 55, 38. Let's move Spark right up into its face. Let's encourage it to maybe attack the Spark over us. 92, 78. 67. I was hoping for the decent shot on the Sectoid, in all honesty. Get a shot on the Sectoid there. We're kind of really hedging our bets on killing that Sectoid. Which I think is possible, but it's... Also setting up really risky plays at the same time. So maybe we just take out the Psy Zombie. Go for the kill here with Rook. 92% chance to do 6-8, which is almost a guaranteed kill. And you've got 8 health, so we'd have to get the best possible shot after the 67% dice roll. So yeah, I think we kill the Viper here. Oh my god.
Minimal damage on target. I require
You're not ammo. Telling me those kind of odds. Why? Okay, let's try kill the zombie then. Alright, zombie's down. Josh, you really need to hit that Viper. 38. Alright, we'll move up and probably get better odds. 59, 48. Take it. It's one less action for our opponent. Missed and dealt one damage. This is going about as bad as it can go. Alright, hopefully they focus fire on Spark. Yeah, not doing such a thing. Grab Josh. She's fine. Ish. We can get him out of that. And shoot Spark. Okay. So, Jesus Christ, what the hell happened there? Oh, the wall exploded. Cool. Right, if we kill the Viper, we get Josh back. Josh gets a hit on the sectoid. So, you got 55 and a 41. Let's take the 41 to unleash Josh upon the world. Blood Gold, it's your time to shine, buddy.
Target
You're doing
neutralized.
This. Alright. Now we've got an extra unit. We can get right up in his face. Right here. And get a shot. We can do the same with Spark. 75. 0% chance to crit. Don't you dare miss. There you go. That's 5 damage. And then we've got a reload, unfortunately. We could go for a strike, actually. Which is 91% or a 67. I think we're taking the 91. I'm done taking chances in this. Plus, it's really cool. Get wrecked. Alright. Is that the last of them? Somehow, I doubt it. Spark got a promotion, though. It is not the last of them. Alright, let's try and regroup a little bit then. We get the free reload, so we'll just Overwatch instead. Oh yeah, we lost the loot there. Okay, so reload. And give yourself a heal. We'll then reload with Blood Gold, get him ready to fire. And pistol Overwatch. And Overwatch you. Actually, we can move you first and then Overwatch. Let's gather everybody together again. And then Overwatch Spark unit. They must be around the back here or in the building. We've got view of the building though. So maybe they're back here. Let's move outwards with Spark.
Just a moment.
See if we can get line of sight around the side of this carrier. Nothing. I don't know where they might be.
Scanning for targets.
Alright, full cover there for Josh. And Overwatch. Overwatch Blood Gold. And then let's bring Alex around here. Overwatch. There we go. We found you. There's an officer as well. Unfortunately, no skulljacking for us. Do get a hit on the officer though, which is pretty good. Hopefully that triggers them all and gets them to come around and trigger the rest of our Overwatches. I need them in line of sight of Blood Gold. Nice bit of damage there on the shield bearer. Blood Gold, have you got a hit? You've got a single hit, so we're going to take it right now. 15%. You haven't missed all day, so come on. Let's do this. We all knew you were going to miss that, let's be fair.
I got nothing.
Alright, free reload for Alex. 45 and a 36. We could land a grenade there, but we destroy some of the valuables, unfortunately. Spark, what have you got? 60%. Really do we're taking out that shield bearer. So I'm going to bring Spark around here. We also want to shred its armor as well. 48. I'm overdriving. 2 50-50 chances to kill the shield bearer. Seems pretty good. Let's do this. Nice. Shredded his armor. He's on one hit, which means Josh can kill him, hit or miss. So, let's land a grenade, I think. What's your odds again? 36. We can kind of, oops, we can kind of destroy his cover right there.
Grenade.
I think we're gonna do that. Let's do it. We know there's another troop around the corner. He's probably gonna try and ambush us. Did not destroy his cover. Got a bit of guaranteed damage in there though. And then we're gonna kill the shield bearer. Hit or miss, it still kills because we got the attachment. There we go. Promotion earned. Alright, 45% chance. Let's take it. Missed. Alright. So they've got two shots on us. Ooh. It's an interesting spot to go. Marks the spark. Okay, that's his turn. We get then the advent trooper who gets a flank on Alex. Oh, Alex. Ah, no. No. Revenge. Revenge. Josh. Murder this man. That is not murdering the man. Okay. I could punch the living crap out of him. I think that's what I'm going to do. Ah, lost two really good units this round. Get absolutely wrecked. Okay, and that leaves Blood Gold into an Overwatch. So if he comes round for a flank, we can potentially get a decent hit. Goes for the Spark unit. 6 damage on the spark, but he is as good as dead now. And that's likely the last of them. Blood Gold doesn't have a hit. So, let's move spark right into a flanking position. See if we can get Josh to get a kill here. I'd much prefer that. Right there. 95% chance. Sweet. Oh, lost one of our best grenadiers.
All hostiles are down and the area is secure. Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
We're going to need to do some more recruiting, unfortunately. Rip. Back to base. She was really good when she was part of this team. She will be remembered. 0.69 enemies killed per turn. Just not in the mood for 69 odds today. That went badly. There was a lot of risky plays from me there. I think that put a lot of people in unnecessary risk, so it's kind of my fault for a lot of that. Really gutted. Alright. Back to the ship. We've got some promotions though as well, I think. I know Spark has got one. And we get to see how badass we can make him. He's going to be out for a while as well. Blood Gold should have had a promotion. Yeah. Everybody who didn't die got a promotion. She was with us for 6 missions and got 8 kills. She was a badass. Alright, Blood Gold. Lightning hands. Fire your pistol at a target. This does not cost an action. Yeah, we're going down the gunslinger route for Blood Gold because it's fun. And we've got Intimidate. When targeted by an attack, the enemy has a chance to panic or Wrecking Ball. While Overdrive is active, break through walls and cover when moving. That seems like it might hurt me more than anyone else if I don't use it properly. We're going to go for the chance to panic. That seems pretty cool. I don't want this guy coming at me, so yeah. And Josh, field medic for 3 med kits in a single round, seems good. Out for 5 days, out for 23 on the rook, unfortunately. And we got a lot of corpses. We didn't get enough trooper corpses, unfortunately. Maybe we can pick some up in the black market though. We got a shield bearer autopsy as well. We are officially low on intel. We've got 35. We need 40 in order to make contact. So, we have idle staff, apparently, in the Proving Ground. Oh, we have no projects. That would explain a lot. Okay. I don't want to do the exosuit, because it takes trooper corpses, and we need them for the normal outfits that we've got. I guess we could go with... Experimental grenades are pretty good. I think I'll wait on that though until after we have our next suits, because it unlocks an extra equipment slot. So I guess we'll go with skull mining.
Sounds good, Commander. I'll let you know as soon as the project is ready for deployment.
Yeah. Okay. And just before we end off the episode, let's go back to... Ooh, supply drop available. It's the same one again. For alien alloys, we need them. We do need them. We're going to Resistance HQ. We're going to purchase some soldiers, hopefully. See what we've got. It's not a lot of the character pool stuff.
Welcome, Commander.
Yep, Dave Lister there. 185 supplies for a sergeant sharpshooter, though. Don't really need a sharpshooter at the moment. And an engineer for 190 supplies. No. Let's check out the grey market. Avenger, the black market, sorry. Course. See if we can buy some trooper corpses.
The market is open.
Can buy alien alloys, autopsies, supplies, advanced stocks. 90 intel short of that. I'm not sure. I am not sure at all. I'm very interested in my focus, I see. Anyway, guys, I think we'll tackle this on a later episode, so I'm going to leave it off here. If you did enjoy the content, then be sure to leave a like and subscribe for some more XCOM in the future. As always, if you have subscribed and haven't yet done so already, hit the little bell icon right next to the subscription button to be notified when I release new videos. Alright, guys, I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.